Yes. does it look like in heaven? Is it peaceful? Is it free like they say? And does the sun shine bright forever? Have your fears and your pain gone away? 'Cause here on earth it feels like everything good is missing since you lived. And here on earth everything's different. There's an emptiness. And oh, I hope you're dancing in the sky. And I hope you're singing in the angels choir. Up in heaven since you arrived. So tell me, what do you do up in heaven? Are your days filled with love and light? Is the music, is the art in advancing? Tell me, are you happy? Are you more alive? 'Cause here on earth it feels like everything good is missing since you left. And here on earth everything's different. There's an emptiness. Up in heaven since you arrived.
Shall we all stand?
In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Praise be God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of mercies and the God of all consolation. He comforts us in our afflictions and thus enables us to comfort those who are in trouble with the same consolation we have received from Him. Blessed be God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ.
God forever.
I bless the body of James with the holy water that records his baptism, of which St. Paul writes, all of us who are baptized into Christ Jesus, who are baptized into his death, by baptism into his death, we were buried together with him. So that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live a new life. For if we have been united with him by likeness to his death, so shall we be united with him by likeness to his resurrection. On the day of his baptism, James put on Christ. The day of Christ coming, may he be clothed in glory. Amen.
We now join in singing our processional hymn from the first page of your leaflet, Sing a New Song Unto the Lord.
Let us pray. O God, to whom mercy and forgiveness belong, hear our prayers on behalf of your servant James, whom you have called out of this world, and because he hopes and trusts in you, command that he be carried safely home to heaven and come to enjoy eternal reward. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen.
Our first reading is from Wisdom chapter 4, verse 7 to 15.
The just man, though he die early, shall be at rest. For the age that is honorable comes not with the passing of time, nor can it be measured in terms of years. Rather, understanding is the hoary crown for man, and an unsullied life, the attainment of old age. He who pleased God was loved. Snatched away, lest wickedness pervert his mind, or deceit beguile his soul. For the richery of paltry things obscure what is right, and the world of desire transform the innocent mind. Having become perfect in a short while, he reached the fullness of a long career, for his soul was pleasing to the Lord. Therefore, he spared him out of the midst of wickedness. But the people saw and did not understand, nor did they take into account the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
In response to our first reading, we sing from the bottom of the first page of your leaflet, "The Lord is my shepherd, he is Lord." Our second reading is taken from Revelation chapter 21, verse 1 to 5a and 6b to 7.
A reading from the book of Revelation. I, John, saw a new heaven and a new earth. The former heaven and the former earth had passed away, and the sea was no more. I also saw the holy city, a new Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, "Behold, God's dwelling is with the human race. He will dwell with them, and they will be his people, and God himself will always be with them as their God. He will wipe every tear from their eyes, and there shall be no more death or mourning, wailing or pain, for the old order has passed away." The one who sat on the throne said, "Behold, I make all things new. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. To the thirsty, I will give a gift from the spring of life-giving water. The victor will inherit these gifts, and I shall be his God, and he will be my son." The word of the Lord.
Shall we all stand to acclaim the gospel?
The resurrection and the life, says the Lord. Whoever believes in me will never die. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Martha said to Jesus, "Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died. But even now I know that whatever you ask of God, God will give you." Jesus said to her, "Your brother will rise." Martha said to him, "I know he will rise in the resurrection on the last day." Jesus told her, "I am the resurrection and the life. Whoever believes in me, even if he dies, will live. And everyone who lives and believes in me will never die. Do you believe this?" She said to him, "Yes, Lord, I have come to believe that you are the Christ, the Son of God, the one who is coming into this world." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
May we be seated, please. Sometimes ones begin to wonder when it comes to funeral, the action of so many becomes so questionable because you attend some funerals, you notice that some family members get upset at every single thing that happened.
Whether the choir sings well, they are upset. Whether the people, person taking the rhythm, takes the rhythm, proclaim the rhythm very well, they are upset about it. When the food comes and the drinks there, they are upset. So everything becomes so disheartening to them. They feel so upset with everything. And once begin to wonder what is the situation, what provokes them. But it's simply because we have different ways on how we lament. We have different ways on how we express our sorrows. Some we express their sorrows in dancing. Some we express their sorrows in drinking. Some we express their sorrows in actually getting upset the way others do. Some will express themselves at their sorrows in actually laughing about it. Some will actually go to the extent of crying. All these are ways on how we treat ourselves, trying to make ourselves comfortable when we are confronted with the reality of death. It is important for us to understand that there's, when it comes to the issue of death, there's no strong man or strong woman. No matter how you claim to be strong, when the body is not there yet, it's not the case when the body is there. Sometimes we feel that the whole program of the funeral should be, the family should allow me to handle it. I am capable of doing everything. I can prepare the food, bring in the drinks, serve everybody, take the readings, and do everything for the family during the funeral. When it is time for programming and doing everything, we want to be at the helm of affairs. But when the reality of the body is presented to us, the body of our family members is presented to us, when it is time for that body to go down, you see that sometimes we are messed up. And so sometimes some person begin to express it in anger. Some person begin to express it different ways. Today in our gospel reading, taken from the gospel of John, chapter 11, verse 21 to 27, Martha expressed her disappointment in Jesus because when their brother Lazarus was sick, they sent a message to Jesus to come. But Jesus delayed to come. For 2 days, he did not come there. For 4 days, he was not there. In fact, for 3 days, he was not there. It was on the fourth day after the death of and burial of Lazarus that he arrived there. So in case you will be taking it for granted that the expression here, Martha said to Jesus, "Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died. But even now, I know that whatever you ask of God, God will give you." Don't think that she expressed that in a very soft tone. She might have been so upset with Jesus, because she knew very well that Jesus had the power to remove that sickness out of their brother. She knew very well that Jesus had the power to stop that death. But why would Jesus delay for 3 days and arriving there on the fourth day? And that is why Martha will go ahead to tell Jesus that, "You see, there's no need for you to go to the grave to see him, because by now he's 4 days in the tomb already. He will be smelling. Don't go there." She was really upset, and she expressed her mind to who? To Jesus. But mind you, that does not mean that God the Son was not feeling the pains of the death of his friend Lazarus. But in everything, in every situation, we are called to give glory to God our Father. The delaying of Jesus' arrival at the house of Lazarus was only to give glory to God our Father. And that is why when finally Jesus assembled by the graveside of Lazarus, he called upon God and he said, "Lord, I know you hear me, but today I am doing this so that I will prove your greatness among these people surrounding me." And that is why he went ahead to invoke Lazarus and call upon him, "Lazarus, here, come out." And the dead man came out of the tomb. Today, it is not impossible for Jesus to invoke the name of our brother to come out. But Jesus had already told us in the Gospel of John that this is the only way leading to his Father's kingdom. He had the power to overcome death. He had everything it takes to shine, to remove death in human life. But he allowed himself to be died, to be killed. He died on the cross. He was buried. He stayed in the tomb for 3 days. But on the third day, he resurrected and came back to life. This is a sign for you and myself to know that death has no power over us, as the scripture tells us. St. Paul's letter to the Corinthians reminds us, death, where is your victory? This, where is your sting? The sting of death has been captured by who? By Jesus' death and resurrection. So our assembly here this afternoon is to encourage ourselves. Because as it is, we are so shattered. We are so sorrowful. We are unhappy because of the death of our brother and friends. But what can we do at this moment? The only thing we are called to do is to console ourselves with the words of God coming from the scripture. Also to encourage ourselves, looking forward for the brighter future, for what lies ahead of us, which is not visible now for you and myself to see it and be courageous enough. But Jesus had already told us that I am the resurrection and life. Whoever believes in me, even if he or she dies, will live. And everyone who lives and believes in me will never die. And he turned around to ask Martha and all of us who are here, do you all believe this? The death that Jesus Christ is referring to here is not the physical death that our brother is lying in that wood this afternoon. That is not the kind of death that Jesus Christ has come to prevent us from dying. Jesus is talking about the spiritual death, which is more deadly than the one we, our bodies, are going to face. Because in this particular physical one, it requires of each and every one of us, because out of dust we were created, and unto dust we shall retain. But then what matters is our soul and our lives is what God has given to us, which Plato will tell you that it has been embedded into our bodies. This carcass we are carrying around does not have any effect to dent our soul. Of course, as it is important for us to understand that the death, physical death, is not important. What matters is the spiritual death. And Jesus had already assured us, if you believe in him, you will not experience that spiritual death. And that is the point whereby most of us are lacking behind. And we are called this afternoon to reflect deeply within ourselves in our relationship with God. It is important for us to know that none of us, God has created us so that we will die and be buried and be forgotten in the grave. And that is why Jesus said the grave is only the channel in which you and myself has to pass through to be able to experience his Father's kingdom. He had made a promise to all of us that I am going to prepare you a place, and after I have gone and prepared you a place, I will return and take you with me, so that where I am, you may be too. Some of us will say, Lord, we don't know where you are going. But he emphatically said, you know the way to the place where I am going. And he has already laid down the principles on what you qualify us in meriting that place that he has prepared for you and myself. Our brother James is on earth, is finished. But does it mean he has finished his journey with God? No. Death is just the beginning of another chapter in our lives. And death has begun a chapter in his life whereby he will now face his creator to reunite with him and have that joyful moment. Of course, the place that Jesus had already prepared for you and myself is so beautiful, so much so that nobody has ever gone there and has come back to meet us. That is why, no matter how beautiful this life might be to you and myself, there's no way you will go there and come back. None of us who have gathered here this afternoon has experienced that. We have celebrated the funeral of anybody here, have taken that person's body to the cemetery, and 2 days after that we have seen that person. Which means that place that Jesus has made a promise to us is the most beautiful place. So let us have faith and trust in God that since it is a beautiful place, we work so hard here on earth to be able to make it into that beautiful place. Our brother has gone to that beautiful place, and our hope is that one day we shall see him again and rejoice with him in our Father's kingdom through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Eternal rest grant unto James, O Lord. May his soul rest in peace. Shall we all stand as we offer our prayers to God, our Father, on behalf of our brother?
The person responsible for reading the reading prayers, please come forward.
God, Almighty Father, raise Christ, his Son, from the dead. With confidence, we ask him to save all his people, living and dead.
Our prayer response, hear our prayer. In baptism, James Haynes received the light of Christ. Scatter the darkness now and lead him over the waters of death. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayers.
Brother James was nourished at the table of the Savior. Welcome him into the halls of the heavenly banquet. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayers.
Many friends and members of our families have gone before us and await the kingdom. Grant them an everlasting home with your Son. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayers.
Many people die by violence, war, and famine each day. Show your mercy to those who suffer so unjustly these sins against your love, and gather them to the eternal kingdom of peace. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayers.
Those who trusted in the Lord now sleep in the Lord. Give refreshment, rest, and peace to all whose faith is known to you alone. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayers.
The family and friends of James Haynes seek comfort and consolation. Heal their pain and dispel the darkness and doubt that come from grief. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayers. God, our shelter and our strength, you listen in love to the cry of your people. Hear the prayers we offer for our departed brothers and sisters. Cleanse them of their sins and grant them the fullness of redemption through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Sit. You may be seated. At this time, we have our collection. We ask for two volunteers to assist in collection. And during this time, we sing all that we have found on the second page of your leaflet.
Thank you.
register. Could the four witnesses please join Mr. Gray to my far left? And during this time, we have a special rendition.
Thank you, ma'am.
Please stand.
Following the teaching of Jesus our Savior, let us together say, Our Father, who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come,
thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Trusting in God, we have prayed together for James, and now we come to the last farewell. There is sadness in parting, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we shall see James again and enjoy his friendship. Although this congregation will disperse in sorrow, the mercy of God will gather us together again in the joy of his kingdom. Therefore, let us console one another in the faith of Jesus Christ.
We now sing from the third page of your leaflet, Sing Out My Soul.
Oh,
invite the immediate family members to come around him for final blessing, please. Our response shall be, receive his soul and grant him, receive his soul and present him to God the Most High.
Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High.
Saints of God, come to his aid, hasten to meet him, angels of the Lord.
Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High.
May Christ call you, take it to himself. May angels lead you to the bosom of Abraham.
Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High.
Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him.
Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High.
Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our brother James to the sheer and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, he will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestow upon James in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn to us and listen to our prayers. Open the gate of paradise to your servants and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurance of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our brother forever. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
May the angels lead you to paradise. May the martyrs come to welcome you and take you to the holy city, the new and eternal Jerusalem. May the choirs of angels welcome you and lead you to the bosom of Abraham, and where Lazarus is poured no longer, may you find eternal rest. Whoever believes in me, even though that person dies, shall live. I am the resurrection and the life. Whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. In peace, let us take our brother to his place of rest.
As we take our brother to his final place of rest, we join in singing from the bottom of the third page of your leaflet, "This World Is Not My Home."
Are your days filled with love?
saved? Does the sun shine bright forever? Have your fears and your pain gone away? 'Cause here on
singing in the angels' choir.
Is it peaceful? Is it free like they say? And does the sun shine bright forever? Have your fears and your pain gone away? 'Cause here on earth it feels like everything good is missing since you lived. And here on earth everything's different. There's an emptiness. And oh, I hope you're dancing in the sky. And I hope you're singing in the angels choir. And I hope the angels know what they have. And I bet it's so nice up in heaven since you arrived. So tell me, what do you do up in heaven? Are your days filled with love and light? Is the music, is the art in advancing? Tell me, are you happy? Are you more alive? 'Cause here on earth it feels like everything good is missing since you left. And here on earth everything's different. There's an emptiness. Are you more alive?
Since you arrived, Yes. Yes, man.
Now I won't let you hear.
Yes, brother.
Real.
Yes, man. Yes, man.
You are
no.
So like I will you can on TV.
Yeah, man. Yeah, man. Yes, we merci. All right. Oui, oui. Yeah, man. Yes, man. Yes, man. Is that what you
before me, we have to see
people. Okay, okay. Yes. Oui, oui.
Vous parlez sur right.
Oui, hello.
Okay.
Accept my sympathy.
I thought you were taking us from the church from there.
No, because of the... I know they have how many funerals. Mm. And sometimes the traffic does be so bad. Mm. I try to get here before. Mm. But sometimes when they have how many funerals, it's problems to get inside the head.
Mm,
yeah, but it looked like the one they had there, they buried the person somewhere else.
Yes.
And... It looked like they did not, all of them are closed, but sometimes it's difficult.
My life not come.
Yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm. Because it's better I get to the same hospital than if there's one free from right, then I can get hit. Yeah. Okay.
Okay, now.
Yeah. So that's why I'm in the head. Yeah.
Tell me how much I say.
You know, like I said, they are making this out again. Because I know they are not making noise when I try to get it. Because how many times I've seen it, I took it. It's too many vehicles, so traffic doesn't belong. Yeah. Hold on, huh? We're going to check out, okay?
Yeah,
okay, we're going to check out.
Yeah. I'm Thank you. That's not what you're saying.
I don't know what you're saying right now.
Don't worry.
So the Haynes family would like to thank each and everyone who reached out during the time of bereavement. Family greatly appreciates your support. You have yourself a blessed and wonderful afternoon. Also have a great weekend. One love to the max.
I'm taking 20 million and you'll stay the same way. Next one.
What's my check?